Hi, my name is Megan Atuble, and I've been making interactive floor and wall experiences for my entire life. And every week, I come here and teach you how to make a cool interactive effect. So today I'm going to teach you how to make this really interesting floor that changes when you walk across it. So if I walk across it, it becomes a different floor, like magic. Yeah, if you want to learn how to make this, stick around. If you have any questions, you can reach me at info@lumoplay.com. The software that I'm using here is called LUMOplay. It works with any projector. You can download a free copy from our website, and I answer every comment and every email. So if you have any questions at all, or you have a project that you want to discuss with me, please feel free to reach out. I really love hearing about other people's creative projects. Let's go over to my design computer and I'll show you how I made this cool effect. To prepare to make the tile flip effect that I'm going for today, I started with a document in Photoshop that has a grid setup that breaks everything into squares so that I can line up the images that I want to use with these squares, and then I can give the motion maker tile flip template just some numbers, the number of columns and the number of rows, and that's going to give me these perfect squares that are going to flip over and line up with my image. The first image that I created was this simple black and white tile, and I made two versions of this, this one and then an inverted one, and I'll just show you quickly what that looks like. So if I launch LUMOplay, I'm using LUMO Playmaker for all of the effects that I'm making today. And the reason that I am using Playmaker is that it is our agency license tier. We have two different license tiers, Playground and Playmaker, and Playground is sold at cost. So the price that we charge for it is what it costs us to keep each license active. And Playmaker is made for agencies, so it's priced a little bit higher, but what it does is it waives all of the fees for publishing apps that you make with Motion Maker. So if you're making a lot of custom experiences for events or for your clients, then Playmaker is really the license tier that you're going to want to get. If you're only making one or two custom apps, you can use Playground and then just use the pay-as-you-go model to make the custom apps that you want to make. It's around $80 US to publish a custom app made with Motion Maker, and it's a lot more economically friendly if you're only making one or two apps a year. So now that I've launched LUMOplay, I can go into the Motion Maker section and I can click on the tile flip template. So I'm just going to scroll down through all of these. There we go. And then I'm just going to click create. And something to keep in mind when you're using the Motion Maker templates is you want to make sure that your screen resolution on your computer is set to the same size, especially if you're designing on one computer and your installation is using another computer. You want to make sure that the resolution is the same. So if the projector that you're using is 16:9 or 16:10, you want to keep that aspect ratio. If it's 1920 by 1080, then you want to make sure that you're designing your graphics at that size. If you do a slightly different size, especially with the tile flip, it's not going to line up properly in your final display. So you just have to make sure that your display resolution on your design computer and your display resolution on your final installation computer are the same in terms of pixels and aspect ratio. In my case, I'm designing this experience for my floor, and the projector that I use for my floor is 16 by 10 aspect ratio. That gives it a 1920 by 1200 pixel image size. So I designed all of the images in Photoshop to match that image size. Now what I'm going to do here is just go into the tiles and delete all of the default tiles that this effect comes with. The way that the effect works is any motion will trigger all of the tiles to flip over. So while that's happening, I can flip other tiles over, but I won't be able to get to the next image until this whole entire image is revealed. So it's kind of like an interactive slideshow, and you can use this for all kinds of things. You can use it on the wall to display ads, where the ads are triggered or the images are triggered as people walk by. What I'm going to do is make a floor. I'm going to call it Magic Floor, and I'll just give my effect a name right now. And it's going to change different tile patterns that you might see on a floor, and I think it's going to look really neat. So we'll start by getting rid of those, and then I'm just going to go into this folder and select the first squares that I made, and then the second squares that I made. And again, these squares are the same image, just inverted. So if I start this, I should be able to see these tiles flipping over. But what I really want is I want those squares to match up to the rows and the columns that I have. So I can just count these really quickly. So now you can see these are flipping over the squares that I've created the image to fit are flipping over where I want them to flip. So that's exactly what I wanted to test. I'm going to get rid of these images next, but before I do that, I'll show you how I built the design file for this effect. So I'm just going to click save on this and close it, and then open up the Photoshop file. And what you see here are all of my different effects on layers. So I'm not using this. This was just a reference image that I made to make sure that the squares match up. But I did find some nice stock textures. I used the stock site 123RF, and I found images that I could take and make into tiles that fit that square. And as you can see, I'm not sure if you can see, but the grid is still showing up on this, so I can see that it lines up well with the grid pattern. And I made all of these different images with different textures, and I just want to move from one to another. So as you walk across the floor, you're revealing a different floor texture. So it's a magic floor. So I exported each one of these images as a PNG, and now I can go back into my template and go into the tiles, and I'm just going to get rid of both of the sort of test tiles that I made and select all of the other patterns that I want to use. And since I already have it lined up with that grid, this is already all lined up. There's a couple other things that I can change. If I want to add an overlay to this, so a call to action that says walk on me or touch to start, I can do that, but I'm not going to be doing that for this effect. So I'm going to close that up. And for the tiles, I'm already done everything in this section. I've imported my images and I've set the number of rows and columns, so I'm going to close that. Flipping is the last set of settings, so it's, as you can see, this is a relatively simple template. I'm going to turn both the flip duration and the flip delay down a little bit, and that will make the tiles flip over quicker. And I just think that as you're walking across the floor, having that reveal happen quicker makes a lot of sense. So that's basically it. That's my entire effect. I'm going to save it. I'm going to close this. And it will save with a nice thumbnail so that I can find my app later. And all I need to do now is hit publish, and my app will upload to LUMOplay and apply all of the vision code that we use to do the motion tracking, and I'll be able to find that app here. So I can download it. And this app will be available on every single one of the installations that I have connected to my account. So if I want to run it on a wall or a floor, I'll be able to access it. You can see that I made two copies because I like to test things before I start shooting these tutorials. There we go, I can just launch that. and now you can see it on my screen. And I think I have the touch screen disabled right now because my cat was jumping all over it, so I'll have to use my mouse to activate it. But yeah, that's the effect. I really hope that you enjoyed this week's tutorial. I had a lot of fun making this. It's so much fun to watch it in action, and I think it'll be a really neat experience for a sensory lab or for an environment where, you know, you just want something a little bit surprising. The tile flip effect is one of the least used effects that we have. We're looking at ways of improving it, so if you have any suggestions for how we might be able to make this effect a little bit more engaging, please let me know. If you have any ideas for apps and games, let me know. You can always email me info@lumoplay.com or leave a comment. I'll be back next week with another tutorial.